It's AumSum time!
What if salt disappeared?
No problem. I can make everything tasty with a snap of my finger.
Oh, AumSum. Firstly, if salt disappeared, oceans would suddenly turn into fresh water sources. Suddenly, there will be excess water available worldwide for drinking, bathing, etc. Secondly, salt is crucial to human health as it is the main source of sodium as well as chlorine ions in human diet. If salt disappeared, there will be severe health consequences. Thirdly, since ages, salt has been used as a cheap as well as an effective food preservative. If salt disappeared, people may have to use expensive alternatives for food preservation. Fourthly, salt makes everything taste better. If salt disappeared, our favorite foods may not taste that good anymore. Lastly, salt is critical in the manufacturing of plastics, polyvinyl chloride, paper pulp, etc. If salt disappeared, chemical industry will be in for a complete shock. Why is ocean water salty? Several natural processes make ocean water salty. For example, when it rains, the water droplets react with carbon dioxide in the atmosphere and form carbonic acid, making rainwater slightly acidic. This acidic rainwater reacts with minerals present in the rocks and forms new minerals and salts. These minerals and salts are then carried by flowing water to the oceans, thus making the ocean water salty. In addition to this, along the mid-ocean ridges, magma rises close to the oceanic crust. Here, when the salty ocean water seeps into the Earth's crust, it gets hot due to magma. This hot water dissolves more minerals present in the crust and carries them to the oceans through fissures called hydrothermal vents, thus making the ocean water salty.
Why does salt make food taste better?
Wait, I'll explain.
Salt, which is basically sodium chloride, makes almost everything taste better. Whether it is French fries, certain fruits, curries, or even cookies, we like at least a little salt in all these foods. According to researchers, we've evolved to like salt maybe because our bodies need salt for survival.
What? Salt for survival?
Indeed. Sodium present in salt maintains our blood pressure, transmits nerve impulses, etc. Whereas chloride is used to produce hydrochloric acid in our stomach. Hence, to obtain salt, we have gradually developed a taste for it. Thus, salt in food makes it appealing and tasty. In addition to this, it is found that salt suppresses bitterness better than sugar. Researchers aren't sure how. Some researchers suggest that salt neutralizes the bitter tongue receptors, while some suggest that on adding salt, the brain interprets the taste as less bitter. Why is salt added to icy roads?
To make ice tasty!
Nah.
Salt helps melt the ice and thus clear the roads.
What? But how, dude?
The freezing or melting point of water is about 0 degrees Celsius or 32 degrees Fahrenheit. When temperature drops below the melting point, water molecules bond together to form solid ice. However, when temperature rises above the melting point, the bonds break and the ice melts, forming liquid water. Now, when we add salt or sodium chloride to ice, it lowers the melting point, causing solid ice to melt and form liquid even at temperatures below 0 degrees Celsius. Then, the salt dissociates in the liquid water, forming sodium and chloride ions. These ions make it harder for liquid water molecules to again bond together and form ice. Hence, the melting ice does not refreeze and thus helps clear the roads. Is too much salt bad for us?
No. Too many questions are bad for us.
Oh, AumSum. Salt is basically sodium chloride. It is important for various bodily functions such as transmitting nerve impulses, digestion, etc. However, too much of something is never good. Firstly, when too much salt enters our blood, the water content in our blood rises, increasing the volume of blood. As a result, our heart works harder than usual. Secondly, as more blood flows through the blood vessels, it puts strain on their walls. Over time, this causes the walls to grow thicker, narrowing the vessels and thus increasing our blood pressure. Mm-hmm. In addition to this, narrowing of blood vessels means less oxygen and nutrients get transported to the cells, increasing the risk of dementia, stroke, and heart attacks. Lastly, to remove excess salt, our kidneys use more water and we urinate more frequently, thus leaving us dehydrated and thirsty. Can gargling salt water cure sore throat?
No, it produces soothing music.
Oh, AumSum. Gargling with salt water is a common method to treat sore throat, but it is important to note that it doesn't cure sore throat. It just provides some relief. A sore throat is usually caused by bacterial or viral infection. This infection activates our immune system, due to which immune cells, blood, and plenty of fluids reach the site, causing redness, swelling, pain, etc. But how does gargling with salt water provide relief? By osmosis. Osmosis is the movement of water from lower concentration of solute to higher concentration of solute through a semi-permeable membrane. Now in salt water, the amount of solute, that is salt, is relatively higher than the salt present in the tissues of our throat. So, when we gargle, the excess fluid rushes out of our tissues, reducing swelling and thus easing out the pain. Why are tears salty?
'Cause our eyes forgot to add sugar to them.
Just listen. There's no way that our tears cannot be salty because salt, that is, sodium chloride, is very essential for various bodily functions. Sodium in salt conducts nerve impulses, helps all the muscles to contract, etc. Chloride is an essential part of our stomach acid. According to research, there's about 0.5 pound of salt in our bodies. Now, if we have so much salt, it makes sense that our bodily fluids, including sweat, blood, and tears, naturally have some salt in them. Besides this, it would take a lot of cellular energy to make sure that our tears were 100% pure water. Moreover, as some tears are continuously produced to lubricate our eyes, it is believed that salt in those tears inhibits the growth of bacteria, thus preventing infections. Topic: osmosis. Why is grass killed if salt is sprinkled on it? Hey, what are you doing? Don't eat the grass. Fine. As always, ignore me. See, I warned you earlier. Hey, wait! You're making it worse. Don't do that. Look! You spoiled it totally. Alright, don't cry. I will tell you why this happened. This happened because of a concept called osmosis. Osmosis is the diffusion or movement of water molecules from a region of higher concentration of water through a semi-permeable membrane to a region of lower concentration of water. Do you think osmosis took place when we sprinkled salt on the grass? Bingo. You are right. Normally, osmosis does not take place on a day-to-day basis because the grass tries to keep the concentration of water same inside and outside its cells through the process of transpiration. However, when we sprinkled salt on the grass, the concentration of salt outside the grass increased and the concentration of water decreased. As a result, the water present inside the plant started flowing outside due to osmosis. Since most of the water flowed out, the grass drooped down and eventually it died. How were French fries invented?
Don't know, dude, but let's give that inventor a dab.
Yes, surely. French fries are loved all across the globe. But who exactly introduced these golden strips to the world? One popular theory traces the origins of French fries to Belgium. It is said that in Belgium, poor villagers living near Meuse River often ate fried fish caught from the river. However, winters caused the river to freeze, forcing the villagers to find alternative sources of food, thus turning towards potatoes. They cut and fried the potatoes in the same way as they used to fry the fish. Then, during World War I, American soldiers stationed at Belgium were given these fried potatoes to eat. They absolutely love the taste. Since the dominant language of Belgium was French, the soldiers named the fried potatoes as French fries. And voila, French fries were invented.